I am Grandma Sudhakar. Today I want to interpret about one of the topic of intermediate first year botany subject. The topic is angiospermic female gametophyte. Actually, that angiospermic female gametophyte is also known as embryo sac. It's also known as embryo sac. This is an embryo sac. There are three parts in the embryo sac mainly. What are the three parts? First part is an egg apparatus. This total portion is known as egg apparatus. This total portion is known as egg apparatus. Actually, what is egg apparatus? Means that there is a middle cell in the egg apparatus. The middle cell in the egg apparatus is known as egg cell. Whereas the two cells which are present on either side of the egg cell are nothing but synergids. So the middle one is known as egg cell. The two other cells which are present on either side of the egg cell are nothing but synergids. Actually, in the synergids, finger-like projections are present. That projections are known as filiform apparatus. That finger-like projections which are present in the synergids are known as filiform apparatus. Then we'll ask in the public exams about the role of synergids. What is the role of synergids? Actually, in the synergids, filiform apparatus are present. That filiform apparatus which are present in the synergids on both sides of the egg cell are helpful for the absorption and conduction of food materials from the nucellus into the embryo sac. This is nucellus portion, this is internal portion of embryo sac. So they will absorb and conduct the food materials from the nucellus into the embryo sac. So this is the function of filiform apparatus which is present in the synergids. So the role of synergids is nothing but absorption and conduction of food materials from the nucellus to embryo sac. And also that filiform apparatus will helpful in directing the movement of pollen tubes towards the embryo sac. They are helpful in directing the movement of pollen tube from this portion into the embryo sac or towards the embryo sac. This is the first part of embryo sac. So, and next, antipodals. Antipodals. The three cells which are present on opposite direction of the egg apparatus. That means that is known as chelazal end. This is known as micropylar end. So at the micropylar end, three cells known as egg apparatus is present. But whereas the opposite side are on the chelazal end, the three cells are present. That three cells which are present on the chelazal end are known as antipodals. This is known as chelazal end. Chelazal end. And this one is this end is nothing but micropylar end. Micropylar end. So at the chelazal end, three antipodals are present. Next and last part of the embryo sac is nothing but central cell. This total portion is known as the central cell. Actually, this central cell contains two polar nuclei. Actually, this is the cell which one is largest with central vacuole along with two polar nuclei. So, this total portion is known as central cell. In the central cell, two polar nuclei are present in the middle portion of that embryo sac. So, once again, I want to repeat this total topic. The female gametophyte in angiosperms is also nothing but embryo sac. It contains mainly three parts. Number one part is an egg apparatus. That egg apparatus contains in the middle one cell that is known as egg cell. On either side of the egg cell, two cells are present. They are known as synergids. In the synergids, finger-like projections are present. That projections are nothing but filiform apparatus. They are helpful for the absorption and conduction of food materials from the nucellus into the embryo sac. And they are also helpful in directing the movement of pollen tube towards the embryo sac. And antipodals, that antipodals are present on the chalazal end. Three cells are present, that is known as chalazal end. At the chalazal end, that three antipodals are present. But last one is central cell. This cell is very largest with central vacuole along with two polar nuclei. So this is about the structure of embryo sac. Actually, this embryo sac totally contains eight nuclei, but seven cells only. Here, in the egg cell, one nucleus is present, and also synergids also contain one nucleus in each of them. So there are three nuclei are present in the egg apparatus. In the same way, that three antipodals which are present on the chalazal end also contains one nucleus in each of the antipodal cells. In the same way, that two polar nuclei which are present in the central cell also contains two nuclei. That's why total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 nuclei are present in the embryo sac, but only 7 cells, because this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and this cell. So that is known as 8 nuclei and with 7 cells the embryo sac is present. So if you like this video, you please subscribe, and also thank you to one and all.